Now, we briefly talked about our press file structure, but let me dive in and dissect exactly what I'm thinking. So every blog post that we want parsed will have a matching markdown file, and that file is going to be structured in a very particular way. So that's what I'm going to show you now. So I want the file to start with three dashes, followed by any of the fields that the user wants to pass in. So for our example, we'll say title, meaning the title of the post. We'll say my title, and we'll pass in a description. Description. After all of that, we're just going to have three more dashes. And then on a new line, we're going to start the blog post body. So blog post body here. Okay, so we have to write a regular expression to match and be able to separate the head from the body. Now, this is what I'm calling the head, and anything underneath that is what I'm calling the body. So let's figure this out together. So we know that we're going to be matching from the very beginning. So to start from the very beginning, start of line, that's this character right here, that is on shift and the number 6. And after that, we're going to have three consecutive dashes. So how do you do that in rejects? That's going to be, you're going to have to escape a dash, and then in curly brackets, we write 3. Now that is going to be interpreted as 3 dashes in a row. After that, we're going to have some sort of capture group, right? And you wrap all capture groups in parentheses. Now we're going to start with a period, which means that we're going to match everything that is in there. And then we're going to use an asterisk to indicate 0 or more times. And it's even going to be optional, right? Because we may not have anything there. But now if we look at our preview here, we see that it's not quite working yet. And the reason is because we want period to actually match new lines. By default, period doesn't match a new line. So what period is actually matching is everything but new lines. So it's getting through these 3 dashes, and then when it gets to the end, it's not going to the new line. Now to do that, all we have to do is add match new lines, and that's the letter S. All right, now let's set the ending point. So another 3 dashes. Again, we're going to do the exact same thing. So escape a dash, and then curly brackets, the number 3, and then curly brackets. Now you see we're matching that correctly. And then at the end, we're simply going to grab everything else. So we're going to put another capture group, and we're going to say, give me absolutely everything that comes after that. And so in our case, it'll do blog post. Now you do see that it is grabbing the space here, and that's okay. We're going to end up cleaning this up in PHP later on. And there you have the regular expression that we're going to be using to separate the head from the body of our press file. Let's bring that over to PHP Storm. I'm going to copy it and move them back. So in PHP Storm, I want to make a new class, and I'm going to call it press file parser. Alongside with this class, I want to bring that sample blog that we just worked on into our test directory. So in my test directory, I'm going to make a new file. And I'm going to put that inside a blogs directory, and I'm going to call it markfile1.md, MD for markdown. Inside here, I'm going to go back to Chrome, and I'm going to grab this right here. Copy, and then paste. This is just a dummy blog post that we're going to use for testing purposes. So now that we have that here, let's go back to our press file parser class. In the constructor, I want to go ahead and accept a file name. Let's start a new matching test for this. In my features directory, I'm going to make a new PHP class and call it press file parser test. Let's extend the test case. Again, orchestra, test bench, test case. And let's write our very first test for this. The head and body gets split. And that's what that regular expression is doing. It's separating the head from the body. We're going to have to do some further manipulation, but at this point, I'm only interested in being able to do both. So let's do a little bit of wishful programming here. we're going to have some sort of press file parser instance, and we're going to call that through new press file parser. And we know we're going to pass in the directory that we're looking for, right? So that's going to be something like the constants for directory, and then we're going to back up one directory, and we're going to go into blogs and then mark file1.md. Let's go through this one more time. So this is our current directory. So we are inside here, right? We're in this test. So we have to go back one directory, which puts us in our test directory, go into the blogs, and in there we'll find markfile1.markdown. Okay, now we're gonna call some sort of get data on that. So press file parser, and let's call it get data. So that's obviously a method that also does not exist. And then finally, let's make some assertions. So this assert contains is actually what I'm gonna use. So get data is gonna return back basically an array. The first item in the array is gonna be the head, and the second item is gonna be the body. And that's all I wanna assert at this point. So let's copy over this first line, copy. And we're gonna wanna be able to see that inside data. And like I said, on key number one, we'll have the head. Let's copy the second test here, description. Let's put that here. And then finally, let's go ahead and assert that we get this here. Now that's not gonna be in key one, that's gonna be in key two. And that's coming from here. So this is key one right here. So this is what we're expecting to see. And then in key number two, we're expecting to see this. So once we're all set and done, this test should pass. Let's go ahead and run that now. PHP unit dash dash filter. And of course, we blow up. Let's get started. Undefined method, get data. Back in our press file parser class, let's make a new public function, get data. So in our constructor, we're accepting a file name. Let's go ahead and initialize that field now. Let's make it protected. Okay. So what's the first step? Let's call this method called maybe split file. As essentially, that's what we're actually doing. So new protected function, split file. And what we're gonna do here is basically the same thing we were doing here. We're gonna preg match all, and we have an input and an output. Okay. I brought that over. This is that regular expression we've been working on. And as input, that is gonna be this file name. And then as output, we're gonna output to this data. Now this data does not exist yet, so let's go ahead and add that in now. Data. And of course, get data, all this is gonna do is just return this data. This is gonna make a little bit more sense in just a minute here. But now, here's one thing. We're accepting a file name, not an actual string. So this is actually returning simply a string with a path. We need to load that file. Now this is where having TestBench really helps us out, because we have the full power of Laravel. So we're gonna use the file system from Laravel to do that. Let's split this up into multiple lines just for ease. And now what we're gonna do is call the file facade. So illuminate support facades for file. And we're gonna say get, and we're gonna pass in the path. And that is actually gonna return the content of that field. Let's go ahead and die and dump this data at this point right here, just so that we can see what is going on. Back in our test. And there you have it. You see we have that array. And again, the reason being is that we're actually getting the file. So we're accepting a file name through the constructor. We're assigning that to file name. And then the very next step, we're going to split the file. So it's going to preg match all. accept the file's content, and save all the results to this data. Now let's go ahead and run that test one more time. Okay, and it's not working just yet. Let's dive and dump that one more time. DD this data. Okay, so what we see here is that we have an array, but each contains another array inside the array. Now the reason for that is because we're using preg match all, but we know there's only ever going to be one. So if we do preg match instead, let's check out the difference. And there we go. We actually have strings after every key. Let's go ahead and delete those lines and run the test one more time. And there we go. We're at green.